disguised as another dude.
What?
You a dude that don't know what duty is?
Or are you a dude who has no idea what dude he is and claims to know what dude he is?
What the fuck are you guys talking about?
I'm playing other dudes.
I know what dude I am.
You're scared.
I ain't scared. Scared of what?
We're scared of who?
Scared of who?
Come on, guys. We really need to go.
Scared of you.
Jesus.
What's going on?
The dudes are emerging.
These rats, you know. Sergeant Lincoln, Luther.
We gotta roll out.
Nor am I. Father O'Malley.
Put me, Armstrong.
I think I might be nobody.
Son, this is the game. I'm playing his ass. That's my job. That's your job. Roger sold dope to kids. The world is a better place without him. Hey, this man was the biggest major violator in Los Angeles.
I watched that cocksucker operate with impunity for over 10 years, and now I got it. The shit's chess. It ain't checkers.
What you think we're gonna do? We're gonna roll up in the black and white, huh? Slap the cuffs on him, you're under arrest. That's a high roller, dog. Take the money.
I mean, I already told you I'm not gonna take
just
that.
Take
I'm not gonna take
okay,
that.
Okay, don't just burn it, barbecue it, fish fry it. I don't give a fuck, but the boys will feel better.
But fuck their feelings.
Jake, you're not making them feel like you're part of the team.
The team? You guys are fucking insane. All right, I'll go back to the valley. I'll cut parking tickets, you know? It can't be like this.
It is this way, man. I'm sorry I exposed you to it, but it is. It's ugly, but it's necessary.
I became a cop to put away drug dealers, the poisoners, the criminals, not to be one.
You sound just like me. And I know what you're going through. I know what you're feeling. You're scared.
I'm not scared.
Yes, you are. Terrified. Everybody goes through that the first time. I went through it.
The sooner you can match what's in your head with what's going on in the real world, the better you're gonna feel. In this business, you gotta have a little dirt on you for anybody to trust you. And when all this is behind you, there's gonna be a whole other world that opens up for you. I walk a higher path, son. I can give you the keys to all the doors.
Consider for a moment the world a rat lives in. It's a hostile world, indeed. If a rat were to scamper through your front door right now, would you greet it with hostility?
I suppose I would.
Has a rat ever done anything to you to create this animosity you feel toward him?
Rats spread diseases. They bite people.
Rats were the cause of the bubonic plague, but that's some time ago. I propose to you any disease a rat could spread, a squirrel could equally carry. Would you agree?
Right.
Yet I assume you don't share the same animosity with squirrels that you do with rats, do you?
No.
Yet they're both rodents, are they not? And except for the tail, they even rather look alike, don't they?
It's an interesting thought, Herr Colonel.
However interesting as the thought may be, it makes not one bit of difference to how you feel. If a rat were to walk in here right now as I'm talking, would you greet it with a source of your delicious milk?
Probably not.
I didn't think so. You don't like them. You don't really know why you don't like them. All you know is you find them repulsive. Consequently, a German soldier conducts a search of a house suspected of hiding Jews. Where does the Hawke look? He looks in the barn, he looks in the attic, he looks in a cellar, he looks everywhere he would hide. But there's so many places it would never occur to a Hawke to hide. However, the reason the Führer's brought me off my Alps in Austria and placed me in French cow country today is because it does occur to me. Because I'm aware what tremendous feats human beings are capable of once they abandon dignity.
In many ways, the work of a critic is easy. We risk very little, yet enjoy a position over those who offer up their work and their selves to our judgment. We thrive on negative criticism, which is fun to write and to read. But the bitter truth we critics must face is that in the grand scheme of things, the average piece of junk is probably more meaningful than our criticism designating it so. But there are times when a critic truly risks something, and that is in the discovery and defense of the new. The world is often unkind to new talent, new creations. The new needs friends. Last night I experienced something new. An extraordinary meal from a singularly unexpected source. To say that both the meal and its maker have challenged my preconceptions about fine cooking is a gross understatement. They have rocked me to my core. In the past, I have made no secret of my disdain for Chef Gusteau's famous motto, "Anyone can cook," but I realize only now do I truly understand what he meant. Not everyone can become a great artist, but a great artist can come from anywhere. It is difficult to imagine more humble origins than those of the genius now cooking at Gusteau's, who is, in this critic's opinion, nothing less than the finest chef in France.
I know how busy you guys can get.
So, what's the topic of discussion?
I've been hired by Meredith Powell to investigate the disappearance of Paul Allen.
I see, yeah. Paul's disappearance, yeah.
Sir, it's nothing that official. I just have some basic questions about Paul Allen, about yourself.
Coffee?
No, I'm okay.
Paul and ours?
No, I'm okay.
Can you bring Mr.
Kimball.
Mr. Kimball, a bottle of
no,
a Paul
Allen? No, really, I'm okay.
It's no problem. So, what's the topic of discussion?
The disappearance of Paul Allen.
Right. Well, I haven't heard anything about the disappearance or anything, not on page six at least.
I think his family wants this kept quiet.
Understandable. Lime?
No, really, I'm okay.
You sure? I can always get you a lime.
Just some preliminary questions that I need for my own files, okay?
Shoot. So typical, isn't it?
It's just strange. One day someone's walking around, going to work, alive, and then...
Nothing.
People just disappear.
The earth just opens up and swallows them.
Eerie. Really eerie.
What does that mean? More appropriate?
Someone more attuned to my needs.
Look at me, Katie. Stop acting.
Oh, I'm not acting.
I wonder if you even know anymore.
Don't be unkind.
You wanna go? Huh? Go on. Actresses are cheap in this town, darling. I got a lot of money.
Howard, please. This is beneath
no,
you.
No, this is exactly me. You come in here out of the blue and telling me you're leaving me just like that, and you have the nerve to expect graciousness?
I expect a little maturity. I expect you to face the situation like an adult who...
Don't talk down to me. Don't you ever talk down to me. You are a movie star. Nothing more.
Where were you when Paul was suckling at his mother's teat? Where were you? Who was nursing you, poor Eli? one of Bandy's sows. That land has been had. Nothing you can do about it. It's gone. It's had.
If you would just you take this lease, Daniel.
Drain it, Eli, you boy. Drain dry. I'm so sorry. If you have a milkshake, and I have a milkshake, and I have a straw, there it is. That's a straw, you see. Watch it. My straw reaches across the room and starts to drink your milkshake. I drink your milkshake. I drink it up.
Don't bully me, Daniel.
Did you think your song and dance and your superstition would help you, Eli? I am the third revelation. I am who the Lord has chosen. Because I'm smarter than you. I'm older.
I'm your old friend, Daniel.
Oh, I'm not a false prophet.
Help me, please.
Sniveling boy. I am the third revelation. I told you I would eat you.
We're men.
I told you I would eat you up.
We're brothers. We're brothers. We're brothers.